The first step in installing Gateway is to mount the unit to a wall. Gateway intercepts the incoming power supply for a home's electrical system and is typically mounted close to the main electrical service. At a minimum, Gateway requires these clearances from the top and sides of the enclosure. Additional space is required on this side to operate the latching mechanism. Ensure there is adequate clearance to open the front door 90 degrees to maintain code compliance. When choosing a location to mount Gateway, adhere to all local codes for the required working clearance around the enclosure. Keep in mind the maximum allowable communication cable length when selecting mounting locations of Gateway and other Tesla equipment it will be connected to, like wall connector or power wall. Installers can choose from two different sized communication cables, depending on the distance between components. Thinner wire can be used for shorter runs, while thicker wire is required for longer runs as specified here. Before mounting the enclosure, remove the dead front and make the required conduit entrance knockouts. These knockouts can be expanded to accommodate larger conduit, or new knockouts can be made in this area. Be sure to clean out any metal shavings left behind from drilling into the enclosure. Conduit may only enter the top of the enclosure when using this Tesla-provided conduit hub, available in two different sizes. After conduit knockouts have been made, hold the enclosure in place against the wall. Level the enclosure and mark the wall through each of the four fastener holes. For PowerShare Gateway, at least two fasteners must be secured to a structural member to support its extra weight. Drill pilot holes, then use the sealing washers from the accessory kit along with the appropriate fastener for the wall type. Gateway must be mounted in the orientation shown here. Do not mount Gateway horizontally or upside down. With Gateway mounted, install appropriately sized conduit to connect to the incoming power supply, the backup load center, and other Tesla equipment. The next step is to pull wire and make terminations within Gateway.